If you think writing a research paper is a slow, painful climb from abstract to conclusion, think again. Most researchers start their papers the wrong way, and that's exactly why their drafts drag on for months, get stuck in endless feedback loops, or die before submission. But what if I told you that writing a paper doesn't have to take months or even weeks? In fact, one of my mentees, Hazel, wrote a full journal paper in 9 days. 9 days. But here's the twist. She didn't use ChatGPT, she used a simple system that any researcher can replicate. So how did she do it? She didn't start with the introduction. She didn't waste time polishing an abstract that no one was going to read yet. She started from the core, from the heart of the paper, and built everything outward from there. That's the system that I'm going to show you today, and it's the exact same framework I've used to help thousands of researchers publish more than 2,500 articles across disciplines, journals, and impact levels. And it's the exact same system that I've used to build my publication track record. By the end of this video, you will know the exact sequence to follow to write a complete paper fast, one that's professional, submission ready, and structured the way it matches the expectations of top-tier journals. So stay with me till the end, because once you see this system, you will never start a paper the same way again. If you're ready to level up your publication game, give this video a like and hit the subscribe button. And don't forget the bell, so you will be the first to know when I share more strategies for top-tier publication and building a high-impact citation record. Okay, let's get started. You might think a scientific article starts with the abstract, followed by keywords, introduction, literature review, methodology, results, discussion, and finally, conclusion. But if you think that's how you're supposed to write your paper, you, my friend, are completely wrong. See, that's how you structure a paper, not how you create one. The abstract and introduction might come first on paper, but they should be the last thing you write. And there is a very strong logic behind that, one that can literally save you months of frustration. I'll be completely upfront with you. After working with thousands of researchers and helping them publish, I've noticed a clear pattern. Whenever a researcher sends me a draft that starts with an abstract, an introduction, a little bit of methodology and early results, I instantly know I'm dealing with a junior author. And if you ever send a draft like that to your senior co-authors, trust me, they'll see the same thing, immaturity and lack of professionalism. So how should you actually write a paper, and how can you make sure it gets done fast? Here is the system that works every single time. Step one, start from the heart. Let me pause for a second and ask you this. Which part of your paper carries the juice, the meat, the essence of your work? Exactly, the results. That's why you write a paper in the first place, to report your findings, to share what you've discovered, to make a contribution that matters. So that's where you start. Not with the abstracts, not with the introduction. You start with the results section, or more precisely, the heart of it, your graphs, tables, and schemes. That's your story. That's the core of your discovery. Design those first, and everything else in your paper will naturally flow from there. Once you've built the heart of your paper, all tables, graphs, schemes, figures, the next step becomes surprisingly easy, because now writing a results section is just reporting what's already there. Here is what I tell my researchers to do. Open your figures, tables, schemes, graph on one side of your screen and a blank Word document on the other side. Look at each figure carefully and simply describe what you see. Write in numbers, proportions, and correlations. No interpretations yet, just pure results. You will be amazed how fast this section comes together when your data visuals are ready. What normally takes months of frustration can come together in a single focused afternoon. Once your results are on paper, move to the discussion section. Now, this is where you have the chance to show your intellectual muscles. In the results section, you reported your findings. In the discussion section, you explain what those findings mean, how they can address your research problem, and answer your central question. But that's just the first layer. The second layer, and perhaps the most crucial part, is to compare and contrast your findings with the state of the art. And this is where your discussion becomes more than words. It becomes your scientific voice. Go back to the literature from the past 3 to 5 years. The most recent, relevant, and credible studies in your domain. Show where your results agree with the existing work and cite those references. Show where your research disagrees with the literature and cite those references. Do not be afraid of reporting your findings when they are not in alignment with the literature. It's perfectly fine to report results contrary to the findings of the literature. discussion is where you cite strategically, not just to fill the space, but to position your study in the current scientific dialogue. You're saying, here's what's been done, and here is where my work advances the conversation. That's what makes the discussion one of the most valuable sections of your entire paper. And if you're part of the AAA program, you already have a step-by-step blueprint for this. All you need to do is to fill out the template, and your results and discussion will practically write themselves. If you need a breakdown of these steps in the meantime, comment the paper below and I'll send you a guide with the step-by-step process. You might be wondering, where's the methodology section then? Well, that's actually step minus one. Yes, minus one. If you are an organized researcher, you should already have this section written long before you even start crafting the paper. Here is how. Every time you go to the lab and complete part of your experiments, come back to your desk and type up exactly what you did, step by step, with the dates, instruments, and parameters. Do this consistently, and by the time you reach the writing stage, whether it's your thesis or your article, your methodology is already done. All you need to do is copy and paste the relevant parts from your lab record. That's what I call working smart, not hard. Now, let's go back to our main sequence. After finishing your discussion section, move on to writing background of the study, or what many call literature review. And why this is the right time to do it? Because right after writing your discussion, your mind is crystal clear about where your work sits in the scientific conversation. Sure, when you first plan your research, you gather a bunch of references for context. But as you progress, as you collect and analyze your data, you naturally come across newer and more relevant studies. At this stage, you are finally equipped to choose the most impactful sources and weave a background that truly supports your finding. And if you are part of the AAA program, you already know this section is practically ready for you in your external validation, which is one of the most powerful blueprints of the program. Now comes the moment of truth. Go all the way to the top of your paper and write your introduction. And here is the secret. This is where the magic happens. You can write 100 different versions of your introduction along the way, but none, absolutely none, will be as strong as the one you craft at the very end. That's because by now, you know the full story. You know what your findings are and how they fit into the literature and what message you want to deliver to the world. That's when you can finally write a jaw-dropping intro like the true champion you are. And if you need a guide on writing the perfect intro for your research or review paper, I have an entire video dedicated to it. Make sure you check it out. I have included a link in the description below so you can find it easily. Then finish strong. Write your conclusion, wrap up the story like a winner, add your acknowledgement, author's contribution, and of course, finalize your references. And just like that, thank goodness, the body of your paper is complete. Now, go all the way to the top of your draft and write your abstract. Don't you dare doubt yourself at this point. You are ready. You're beyond ready. There is no better moment to write an abstract than after you have completed every other part of your paper, because now you finally know what your paper is truly all about. Now you can summarize it with precision and power. Add your keywords carefully, make sure they truly reflect the essence of your research and help your article get discovered. And when it comes to your title, keep it clean, sharp, and realistic. A title that communicates the core of your paper will always outperform one that tries too hard. Cut the fluff. Avoid self-praising adjectives like novel, innovative, new. If your work weren't novel, it wouldn't be suitable for a journal submission in the first place. And there you have it. You're done. Like, really done. You have written your paper the smart way, the professional way, the way senior researchers do it. Writing a paper never moves up a vertical axis. It's not a bottom-up structure. It starts from the core, from the heart, and branches out to form a complete draft. That's the most efficient and sustainable way to do it. So go try this system and let me know if you managed to break Hazel's record. I can't wait to see you win your breakthroughs, those big, happy, proud moments in your academic journey, because trust me, they're coming. You've got this. And if you're ready to step up to build a complete strategy for getting published in top journals and building a visible research career, then book a free strategy call with me. I've included the link in the video description, and I look forward to chatting with you.